President Obama getting ready for a tightrope walk at the White House. What could be a cornerstone speech for the commander-in-chief only a few hours from now set the layout as plans for winding down the 10-year war in Afghanistan and warnings from military brass that a hasty exit could negate years of progress. John Bolton, former U.S. ambassador at the U.N. and a Fox News contributor, and good morning to you, Mr. Ambassador. Is this the right call?
No, I don't think so. I mean, let's be realistic. We wouldn't even be talking about a major presidential speech or calculating how many troops he's going to announce withdrawing if the president himself hadn't set up this very artificial deadline back in December 2009 when he announced the U.S. and NATO surge in Afghanistan to begin with. It was a mistake to create that kind of deadline then, and it's a mistake now to follow through on it, and particularly to withdraw people. It's true we've had some success in the past several months, and that's much to be applauded. But, you know, if you're playing football and you get down on your opponent's 20-yard line, you don't say, okay, time to pull some players out of the game. You increase the pressure.
Well, that or here's the ball. Here's the fact that we believe. Phase withdrawal, 5,000 by the end of the summer. Another 5,000 by winter or spring of next year, 2012. We're hearing even from Republicans who believe this is the right call. There's more concern about the debt and what we're spending. You hear John Huntsman in his announcement from yesterday and again earlier today that, you know, now's the time. Huntsman actually went a step further. He says 10,000 is not nearly enough. It has to be faster than that. What do you think?
Well, I think Governor Huntsman is flatly wrong on that. You know, this is exactly the time to increase pressure on Taliban. It is not the time to begin withdrawing. It's certainly not the time to negotiate. I think the measure of troops we put in or pull out in the president's speech is as much a consequence of the president's political calculation as it is our strategy on the ground. You know, he's trying to thread the needle. He told the Democratic left he was going to begin a withdrawal of the surge forces this summer. He will do that. But he greatly fears a military debacle on the battlefield. So I think he's going to try and stretch this past the 2012 election. And that will account for the delay in the withdrawal of the others. And I think that simply highlights how much at risk we still are. Once that 2012 election is gone, the president's free of his last electoral constraint, I'd be very worried about what he did then.
Well, we get a lot of questions on this, and we'll wait for the announcement later tonight. BYA now, because you asked. We got this from Dee Jansen of Indian Hill, Ohio, writing, why the preoccupation with announcing to the world, Taliban included, the when, where, and how of our planned troop deployment during World War I, II, Korea, and Vietnam. Anyone releasing details of troop movements, numbers, or configuration would have been eligible for a firing squad. Just curious. Are we sending too strong of a signal to tell the Taliban, Al-Qaeda, to lay in wait?
Well, I think it's inevitable in our society as it is today, and it really started with Vietnam. It's very hard to hide what the troop figures are going to be. So the issue is not making them public. I think they're going to become public in any event. The real question is the strategy underlying the decision. And here I think a signal of withdrawal is a signal of weakness to the Taliban. And I know, as you said a moment ago, people question the cost. What's the cost of not defending ourselves? This is not a choice between fighting in Afghanistan and rebuilding America. It's the choice between a safe America and an unsafe America. What do you put the cost of that?
You're running for president?
I'm thinking about it. These are the kinds of questions that get me going.
I bet they do. A decision comes when?
Well, no later than Labor Day. I think, practically speaking, you have to make a decision by then just to get the logistical apparatus of a full-scale campaign up.
Sounds logical. Yeah.